Hi, and welcome to another episode of Collect Plays, where I play through a game, generally start to finish, usually in one session, games that are typically too short to go on my regular stream over on Twitch, or that just don't quite fit my streaming schedule. Tonight's game is, of course, another spoopy indie horror game, because I've been working my way through them, and it is called Convenient. The first game from Luna Apps, this game has you going to a convenience store to get some gas on your way home and discovering that the rumors were true about the place, and we now have to escape the old lake stalker. Oh boy. So this game does feature some PS1 style graphics. Gotta have my on. It is supposedly short, according to the Steam page. There are no random jump scares, and it has multiple endings. So let's see if we can find all of the endings, alright? Let's get on over to it. So as always, we're going to start with my settings, because I'm curious. We're going to pipe that music down to about half. We're going to make sure it is at full. Oh, that is full screen. All right. And everything else is good. So that's all we got. Let's play. Got our trusty heart rate monitor over there. Okay. Gas station. All right. Gas. Okay, I want to pick it up. Pick it up. Pick it up. Pick it up. Tab. Escape. Oh, okay. Go inside, maybe? Up. $10 on pump 2, please. Where are you coming from? Cotton Eye Joe. Just driving home from visiting family. You shouldn't be out this late. I need to be home by 8 a.m. I almost ran out of gas on the way here. That's a shame. Anyway, just $10 on pump 2, please. Sure thing, sweetie. First off, what the fuck is this face? And second off, motherfucker, I didn't give you permission to call me sweetie. Creep. Air. I think there's something wrong with the pump. I know. It does that sometimes. Let me just reset it for you. Okay, you should be good to go for now. Thanks. It's locked. Get up. Well then. The buttons don't work. I'll have the key. Water. Okay, we got all that, but why is it snowing in the house? Give me Lex Rupert only says previously investigating here due to higher knowledge experiences others in the Old Lake County community are accusing a cult practice. Local authorities have refused to comment. Ew. Sure, everything was where it was before a good event. Okay, here we get up. All right. Okay. So I think the clock ticking was the indicator that he's coming. Okay, so we gotta find the combination for the door. 0527. Now I'm not hearing him. Would have thought I would have. All right, 0527. So break that, wait for him to come down. Have time to get all the way down. Do I have to actually walk in first? Okay. Getting faster. Oh shit, I forgot to close the door again. So, probably gonna die again because I forgot to close the door again. Yep. Although, to be fair, if he's gonna kill you anyway, why didn't he just kill you when he kidnapped you versus all this bullshit? It's not a lot of story to this game, to be fair. It's just pretty much, you went in, you had a creepy clerk, pump didn't work, and then he knocked you out so he could kidnap you and murder you, and he's already got somebody else in the house, too, because apparently one's not enough for him. This time I close the door. And I change myself back up, and I'm back asleep. Meet at the altar. Bitch, you could fucking run for your life! Right, damn if I wouldn't be running down that street. Get the fuck up out of here. What the fuck? Take that gun ammo too. Okay. Get the fuck up out of here. We got the good ending. Woo! I went to the police station as soon as possible. Looked like they agreed to take a look there. Around since I told them there was a dead monster there. They thought I was lying, but they saw it for themselves. The disappearance of Oakland have stopped, but I'm still recovering from what I've witnessed. Secrets found, 0 of 4, good ending. So, were the other two. Okay. So, what are the other two? Find the bad ending. Being murdered wasn't the bad ending. And find the secret ending. Okay. I am mildly curious as to what the bad ending was if it was not being murdered by the dude. Or what the secret ending is, if it again was not being murdered by the dude. I'm curious. Okay, so the secret ending is basically unlocking some hidden stuff and you find yourself in a back rooms type game. I can pass on that one. I can pass on that one. And the bad ending is to not die by the Wendigo thing immediately, but to have it chase you and then make it to the car with it chasing you, which seems silly. So, I'm good with getting the good ending when we finally got an ending. I'm good with calling this one done. Like I said, this is called Convenient. It is a game from Luda Apps. It is normally $2.99 on Steam, so it's a very cheap, inexpensive game. And I mean, it's a short little fun game. You kind of have that. It's a very simple puzzle game. It's not super complex. You really just have the puzzle of figuring out what to do in order to not get caught by the killer. Now, theoretically, if you're a better gamer than I, maybe you could do all that without keep going back to sleep like I was trying to do, because maybe you could outrun him. I don't know. I wasn't about to try that. But I had fun. That definitely was a fun little game. The killing animation was freaking hilarious. It has almost no story, but it's a fun, quick little spoopy spoop. And I think I got it on sale, so certainly worth playing if you like the short spoops, you like the funny spoops, and you like supporting a new indie developer, because I believe the Steam page, let me double check. Yes, and this was their first horror game, so yeah, why not give it a try? If you would like to give it a try, the link for the Steam page will be down in the description below. If you decide to try to get the bad ending and the secret ending, I'd love to know. Love to know what they were, what you thought about them, if you had fun with them. Did you find all the secrets? I'm being lazy. I'm not looking for the secrets. I had fun with just the part I had. The gun especially is so badly animated. It's hilarious. It is so PS1 minus the hand. So great cute, not cute, but great fun little game. What, 25 minutes, something like that. Not a very long game, and that's with me dying multiple times and just getting one ending. So I think you can, I think for the price, it's not bad at all. It's not bad at all. Like I said, I think it's worth playing. But like I said, the link for the Steam will be down in the description below. If you'd like to watch me playing games live and in person and all the thirsty, crazy shenanigans that get on during my stream, sometimes I wear cat ears, I've been caught in a maid outfit, I'm a thirsty bitch, I say a lot of stupid ass shit, because I don't always get the filter going. Follow me at twitch.tv.com. If you'd like to see more of my Let's Plays videos, feel free to hit the subscribe button. That'll be on one side of the or the other. And if you'd like to see more Let's Plays, click the box. You know how the YouTubey works. Go for it. And until next time, thanks for watching, and take care of yourself, all right? Bye-bye!